1, 2, 3. I'm a gang beater, I'm buzzing round. I'm a gang bee, buzzing all night long. I'm a gang bee, buzzing all night long.
Once again, scenes from the Antiques Mall, where I cleaned up and got those jazz records that I showed recently. I also found some blues records while I was there, and also a kind of a smattering of things in the pop rock era. I have to admit that the pop rock stuff had been pretty well picked through, so the stuff that I found, while I wanted it in my collection, it's not all that exciting and maybe not worth doing a video about it. But I did find some blues records that I'm pretty pleased with, and so I thought I would show those in addition to the jazz records that I found. First up is an album by Alexis Korner. This is called Get Off of My Cloud. And I was familiar with the name Alexis Korner and knew that he had something to do with the very early British blues scene in the 60s, but really had no idea how influential he was until I started reading some of these vast liner notes here. Just to give you an idea, up here at the top there's a quote from Pete Townshend of The Who. It says, "Alexis Korner has had a great influence on the British blues scene. If only for helping bring the Rolling Stones together, Alexis should be carried around London in a sedan chair for the rest of his life." And again, that was Pete Townshend of The Who. Again, there's sort of a liner notes that are not in the liner, they're all over the front and back of the album. Various different people, biographer, looks like a biographer of Bob Dylan and Mick Jagger has done much of this. But there are quotes from various different people on here. "Without a doubt, it was Alexis, together with the late Cyril Davis, who was directly responsible for nurturing the way in which most progressive blues and pop in this country was developed. For it can virtually all be genetically traced back to his band, Blues Incorporated." And that was Roy Carr from New Musical Express, NME. Apparently an incredibly influential person in the British blues scene, the early British blues scene. I have to admit that I don't know much about him. Perhaps I should, but I don't. So I'm looking forward to not only, you know, sort of reading the rest of these in depth, but also listening to this record. If anyone is watching this and knows more about Alexis Korner than obviously I do, which isn't going to be hard to do, definitely send me some comments. I'd love to hear more about this guy. Sounds pretty amazing. Much more contemporary than that, the Robert Cray Band, Bad Influence. I don't know where this sits in Robert Cray's discography. I have a feeling it's fairly early. I'm just looking for a date. 1983. So Robert Cray Band, Bad Influence. Again, a blues musician that I'm somewhat familiar with, but obviously far from an expert. I also found this record, Red Hot, from Boogie Woogie Red, on Blind Pig Records from Ann Arbor. I don't know anything at all about Red Hot and Boogie Woogie Red. I'm assuming Red Hot is the name of the album, and Boogie Woogie Red is the name of the artist. But I am familiar with Blind Pig Records from Ann Arbor. It's a small label from Ann Arbor, Michigan. And it just looked like a pretty cool record. And, you know, it cost a few bucks, so I figured I'd give that a try. Something a little bit closer to home to where I am now, where home is now, Hound Dog Taylor and his House Rockers. So this is on Alligator Records out of Chicago. So anyway, Electric Blues there. Really looking forward to giving that a spin. I'm assuming, based on that look on that cover, I'm assuming we got some boogie woogie happening here. Should be a good record. One that I am much more familiar with is One Way Out from Sonny Boy Williamson. Sonny Boy Williamson, a harmonica player who also had quite an influence on the early British blues scene. He has worked with the Yardbirds and the Animals, recorded with them, done shows with them, that sort of thing. And One Way Out, if you're an Allman Brothers fan, that's the same song. So if you know that one, I think it's a Willie Dixon song. I could be wrong about that. But anyway, really pleased to find that. It's in really good shape. Sonny Boy Williamson, One Way Out. Live album from Muddy Waters. Just called Muddy Live. Muddy Mississippi Waters Live. That's from the days when he was, his latter period, when he was working with Johnny Winter. As a matter of fact, Johnny Winter is on this record. Johnny Winter plays guitar on this record. James Cotton, Willie Big Eye Smith, Pine Top Perkins, Barb Margolin. Those guys from the Nighthawks, I think. Anyway, good stuff. Live Muddy Waters. And no ringware or anything. It's a black cover. It's in beautiful shape. And then I could be wrong about this, but I think this is the last Muddy Waters record, the last record he ever recorded, called King Bee. 1981. It's again produced by Johnny Winter. Johnny Winter, I don't know how many people are familiar with this, but towards the very end of Muddy Waters' career, there was a bit of a resurgence in his popularity, and a lot of that had to do with Johnny Winter. Johnny Winter kind of did a Rick Rubin on Muddy Waters, in the same way that Rick Rubin has sort of revitalized Johnny Cash's career, or even Neil Diamond's career with some of the production that he's done. Johnny Winter did the same thing for Muddy Waters back in the late 70s and early 80s. And like I said, I believe this was Muddy's last album. So anyway, just some blues finds from the Antiques Mall. Thought I'd share that with you. Kind of a companion piece to the jazz records that I found. So if you didn't catch that video, if you're catching this one and you didn't see the video that I did on the jazz records I found at the flea market, or at the Antiques Mall, I will put a link to that below. And you can find it there if you're interested. Okay. Talk to you later.